I am tired of hearing about knee pain being the reason that somebody stops running. This is by far the most common response I get when I ask people what happened. You were liking running for so many weeks, so many months, like why did you stop? It always comes back to their knees. So whether you are somebody that goes out and it hurts for the first mile or two and then it goes away, or maybe it doesn't hurt in the beginning, but halfway through it starts to feel tweaked, or it doesn't hurt at all on the run, but you come home and you sit and then you stand up again and you feel that tweak. Any of these categories leads me to believe that your tissues are not being taken care of. So I'm giving you a really short routine to use before and after your run to guarantee that knee will be in good shape, you won't be feeling that pain, and you won't have to be sidelined again. Okay, so you are gonna go grab a foam roller, a lacrosse ball, a ball that's a little bit bigger than that for mobility, coffee mug, wine bottle, any of those things will work. You're gonna go grab it and meet me right back here. Okay, found that foam roller. I hope you guys found something to use as well. Again, anything will work. Before we get into this routine though, I need you to understand why your knees hurt in the first place. A lot of you probably know by now, it wasn't some traumatic incident that caused the tweak in the first place. It just kind of showed up one day. But I'm here to show you why. You take several thousand steps in a run. That leads to so many opportunities to land poorly. So if you don't prime the body to absorb shock in the best way that it can, you're gonna see some problems. If it's not the knee, it's gonna be the ankle or the hip or maybe even the back. So I want you to understand how landing efficiently can really save you over time. So one of the types of runners we see often is the heel striker. This isn't to say that you run every run using a heel strike, but generally it is your main mode of transportation. And you can see the more you step out, the more you're asking from your body to do on the landing before rolling over. So instead of using glutes and hamstrings to land with your foot, you're striking with the heel, and then you are using the angle of your knee and ankle to then push over and get your body weight on top of that. So this next one I like to call the marathon shuffle. If you've ever been at the end of a marathon or the end of any really long run, you know the feeling of just not being able to pick your feet up off the ground anymore. And so what happens here is you are not following through the whole rotation of your stride. So you're actually cutting it short and landing on the ground before you've come all the way through. And that's why you get that kind of scuff sound on the ground. Again, this one is just lack of efficiency in the running, but it's really just a heavy landing and it's really not great on the joints. So both of those being said, what we want here is for you to push your hips forward to engage the glutes and hamstrings to get the most long-lasting endurance from your run form. And so what you're gonna do is just keep those hips pushed forward. You wanna find a pulling motion with those feet off the ground so that you're landing basically right under you. I like to call it a mix between a high knee and a butt kick. It really is just picking your feet up right under you. Practicing in a drill is a great way to do it, and then kind of just building it into your run in a smaller version. It's a really, really nice way to see less impact on those knees. Now you can see there are so many ways to land when you run, but the goal is to create the best pulling motion you can, which will require adequate mobility, range of motion in your ankles, hips, and knees. We're gonna make sure you have that right now. All right, we are back down on the ground. We've got our foam roller here. We've got some work to do. Again, just 5 minutes or less before your next run. This is what we're gonna do. You're gonna start with your bottom of your inner thigh, so the bottom of that adductor. So what I'm gonna do is just find a spot on the roller near the knee. Confused. You can angle it in so that you have space here. Find that spot right above the knee here, and all you're gonna do is lay on the elbows. You're gonna just start by little flex and extend to see if you're in the right spot. So this is kind of how we do a scan before we run. See what's kind of flared up, what might flare up that we don't feel right away until maybe a few minutes into the run or whatnot. If you don't feel much, go ahead and take a little lateral roll side to side. You'll find a spot that feels it. And then from there, we'll go some bend extend, just like that. Remember, if you are propping yourself up, just keep that core engaged. Make sure you're not just sinking into bad positions at the expense of getting to other areas of the body. And we'll just spend 1 minute here. That's it, just 1 minute down near the knee. You can hit a few different spots if you want. Of course, this is all built into a bigger warm up, hopefully, but if nothing else, get this 5 minutes in. 1 minute down there, we're now gonna go up to the upper part of the adductor. Foam roller does work for this, but I will say, I think the best tool to use would be your ball, kind of a medium-sized, a little bit bigger than a lacrosse ball. You can actually raise yourself up and get on a coffee table or a chair, hard surface, and then get this underneath. And what that's gonna do, show you guys here, is just make it so that you can actually get deep into the top of the adductor, and sometimes it's hard to feel this if you don't have that smaller surface area. So I just kind of roll side to side here, feeling it out again. The reason we get in pain or the knee starts to feel residue from the rest of the poor body mobility is that you're not giving your muscles the correct length to use. So at optimal length, they're doing what they're supposed to be. If they're shortened or they're tight, they aren't, and somewhere else has to compensate. So the same way you use your legs to deadlift something off the ground so that your back doesn't overextend, it's the same thing here. You wanna make sure that all this tissue is ready to go to do its best work during that run so that your knee doesn't take that pounding when you land. So just rolling back and forth, very simple. Like I said, 1 minute up here, 1 minute down here. Final thing we're gonna hit is the calves. So I take this, I'm gonna sandwich it right between in the knee crease here. And I'm just gonna sit back and use my hands here for a little pressure. First thing I'll start with is just side to side. Again, a smaller surface area would give you more intense feeling here. This foam roller is getting more of my Achilles and lower calf than the top, but it's all good anyway because what we're trying to do here is open our ankles up. That pulling motion I showed you guys is really hard to do without good range of motion, the ankles to land flat. If you find that you're always running on your toes, your calves are very tight. That can really add up, increase risk for shin splint, and of course the knee gets sent into a further flexed position, increasing the load on the quads. You lower that heel, you're able to land right under yourself. Again, the glutes and hamstrings can work. And that's ultimately what we want. So I just move around here. If I had something smaller like the ball, I could do one leg at a time, tuck it. Here I'll even get a little hamstring, which is good. And then just rock side to side. So for the calves, just 1 minute is fine with the foam roller, 1 minute on each of the sections of the adductor per leg. And now you're ready to go run. Let's do it. All right, back from that run, just one more little 5 minute routine to hit. We're gonna head inside now and do it. You just need that foam roller again. All right, we are back inside. I had to do a little outfit change. Anyone that knows me knows that I cannot be in my sweaty clothes, even for the cool down, because I'm so uncomfortable that I'll actually do a shorter cool down as a result. So, did my little change, do it if you need to. We're gonna start with a couch stretch. So you can see we're actually using the couch for this, but you can use a wall, any surface that you can get your leg up against. And if you need padding under the knees for this, because you are gonna be propping yourself on them, get a pillow or like a sweatshirt folded up underneath and we will get going. So there's three versions of this depending on how much length you have in the front of the quad and hip. If you're super tight, you're probably gonna go with option one, which is this. I'm just gonna hook my back foot up on the couch here. And of course, if you're against a wall, no worries about that hook. You just have to make sure that you're pressed all the way up against so that shin is vertical against the wall. Now, with the other leg, you are just knee down here. That's all you're gonna do. You're gonna keep the hands down for support. And now what we're gonna do is stretch through the front of the hip. So I'm gonna keep my hands down here for this version. I'm just gonna squeeze the glute, especially on that side of the leg that's up, and I'm just gonna breathe. Nice deep breaths here. You're just trying to get nice long stretch, static stretch through that front of the hip and quad. Now, if that's too easy, what you're gonna do is bring yourself to a foot position on the ground, but you'll still leave the hands down. So I'm gonna bring my foot up. Looks like this instead of the kneeling. Come back here, all right. And now we're gonna just leave the hands down, but again, you'll get more stretch only if you engage the glutes. So you have to keep doing this. So really pinch that back there. And otherwise, just keep that core on tight and breathe. So little pull of the belly button into the spine, that's just to protect everything, make sure you're in good positions. Spend some time here. Again, if it's too easy, we've got one more option for you, and that's gonna be all the way up to the top. Pushing the hips forward, sorry if you lose my head a little bit. I'm just gonna try to find that most vertical position I can, again, squeezing, and breathe through here. And you've got 1 minute of couch stretch per side. Bonus points for doing longer. There's obviously more benefit in doing it for longer. Again, do what version you need to do. This might even change day to day. After we've hit both sides, we're now gonna hit an adductor stretch, a little dynamic one that kind of goes off of what we did with that ball in the beginning. So for this one, you might lose my head on the demonstration, but we're gonna just be stretching out the inner thigh again, and not in a rolling way, but in an actual dynamic stretch. So I'm gonna kick my leg up here. I'm gonna flex my toes up to the ceiling. And with this bottom foot, I'll just have it slightly out from parallel. It's a little turned out. And all I'm gonna do is use this couch as support to find myself in a mini squat. I'm gonna feel a stretch through here. I'm gonna stand back up and find that stretch again. Now, it depends how tight you are here, if you'll actually feel anything right away. The lower I go, if I were to kind of spread the legs out and get low enough that I was really holding onto my coffee table and couch, I could probably feel even more of a straddle stretch. A lot of the straddle stretching you see is just to work this same area, but I like this standing version because you get way more leverage. You get to decide how intense you want it to be. You even get a little bit of work, again, mobilizing through the ankle and hip on the other leg. So what I want you to do is just 15 small little reps here, wherever you feel comfortable. You can put hands on the hips if you want, cores on. And we're getting kind of that top of, near the groin, that top of the adductor stretch, even a little bit near through the knee. So 15 per side on that. All right, runners, final movement today is gonna be for the IT band. So we've hit that adductor religiously. We've gotten the quads now and near the knee itself. We are gonna finish with the outer side here, that IT iliotibial band right now. And so you're gonna grab your roller again. You're gonna start with it on the outside of the knee right above it. And I'm gonna use my elbow for support here. And all I'm gonna start with is a slight roll side to side. Once I find that tight spot, which is basically my whole leg right now, I'm gonna plant this foot and I'm gonna flex and extend with the leg that's on the roller. So just like that, maybe 6 to 8 times here. Get a little movement. Again, I'm making this time efficient for you, but the more time you spend, the more you're gonna get out of it, the less injury you're gonna have. That's pretty obvious. I work up, middle of the leg now. Little scan side to side again. Still try to stay on the outside of the leg. I know it's tempting to get to the quad again, but you wanna just stay out here. And again, we're gonna flex and extend. When you go to that seated position right after your run or whatever you get back to work, your hips are gonna just really shorten and tighten. This ensures that you keep that length going and you're actually gonna sit up a little taller, you'll notice as well, because you're not pulling so tight in the hips and just crunching everything up. You're actually lengthened so your back can stay straighter. Your neck can be up. You actually will just notice better posture as well. Final thing, let's take it all the way to the top. I like it near the glute and then right to the outside of the hip flexor. This one I won't extend, I'll actually just roll side to side. Spend a little extra time there. For bonus points, you can actually bend in and extend this leg that's on there. I find some good hip flexor work that way. But that is it, 1 minute each side on the IT band. All right, the time is finally here. You can get on the couch and relax. You've done the work. You did those steps you needed to prevent knee injury, to stop that pain before it gets you. If you want more on runner's knee specifically, if you've been diagnosed with that, click right over here. Coach Nate did a great 5 steps to preventing and fixing runner's knee video, and it's awesome. So check it out. I will see you guys another day.